Up against Mark Hill, who's in the ring, and his partners are Greg Stone and Joel Eaton outside of the ring. Nick Patrick, a referee, and here we go. Thunderbolt Patterson against Mark Hill in a good arm drag to begin things here today. U.S. Heavyweight Champion Magnum T.A. What a quick win he had last week right here on Championship Wrestling from Georgia. He'll be back with us here today. We'll talk to the NWA Television Champion Dusty Rhodes. We'll also get to talk to number one Paul Jones and his man, the Barbarian. Buzz and Brett Wayne Sawyer both will be here. Tully Blanchard and Baby Doll, the Perfect Ten. Bob Roop. Boy, what a lineup we have here today. Wildfire Tommy Rich with a big knee up against Mark Hill. There's the Boogeyman, and I mean he set him right down with a big hand. Mark Hill hitting the deck hard that time. That time, the Boogeyman allowed the tag to Joel Eaton, and I'm sure Deaton is going to think twice about being in there. A big blow to the midsection. Jimmy Valiant now working in the corner. That was Thunderbolt Patterson with a big hand. Out of the ropes. That time, an elbow from Valiant and a blow to the midsection from Thunderbolt. Patterson with a big arm. And now a face lock, and he hits him once again right up against the side of the head. Wildfire Tommy Rich. Vertical suplex. And hard down goes Joel Eaton. Kicks out, though. Valiant now holding Joel Eaton, and they're really working over Deaton in their corner. He's going to allow a tag again, and now Greg Stone's going to get his chance to work against the Boogeyman. Oh, that was a big hand. Right up on the bridge of the nose that time. Valiant whips him into the ropes, and Patterson once again to the midsection. Also, today we'll get another look at Arn Anderson, a man who was oh so impressive last week when we saw him and used those tactics that have made the Anderson family so famous in the world of professional wrestling. We'll take another look at him here today. Tommy Rich now, right up against the ribs. Rich now, that hand behind, a neck breaker. The neck breaker. Greg Stone went down, but still Tommy Rich now with that headlock applied. Close enough to get a tag, and here comes Joel Eaton. To the midsection again. Wildfire Tommy Rich. You know, Wildfire Tommy Rich is a former World Heavyweight Champion. He held that NWA championship at one time. A belt that Ric Flair now holds. And now Rich is in once again. That was a knee lift. And a snapmare brings him over. Rich working in the corner quite well, and here comes Thunderbolt Patterson. A double thrust. Into the chest. Deaton is reeling. He has to call for Mark Hill, who's going to get much of the same thing. A headbutt. Once again, a double thrust. He's got him covered. And that is it. Bring in Ole Anderson. Ole, last week we talked about your cousin Arn Anderson. We started talking about him, and you said you did not agree with his tactics or the way he held himself in the ring, but you watched him, and you were very, very impressed with Arn Anderson, and rightfully so.
Well, first of all, I don't want to be in a position to correct you, but I didn't say I didn't agree with him. What I said was that there were some people in there who had no business being in there, and I said that Arn is doing the one thing that the Anderson brothers have always been so noted for, or the Anderson family's been so noted for, and that is wrestling. And Anderson's doing it better than anybody else, and I'd have to include Arn when I say it.
Well, I would have to agree with that. No one does it as well as the Andersons, and of course, Arn Anderson was evident of that last week when he saw him. We're going to take a look at Arn Anderson once again this week against Gene Ligon, and I'm sure, Ole, you're going to want to watch your cousin Arn Anderson again. Arn Anderson once again, he comes in, he has a baseball cap on, and one thing you always look at, Ole, you mentioned this last week, he looks an awful lot like you. I mean, there's a obvious resemblance there within the family.
Well, I guess he should, since we're first cousins. It would only make sense that we'd look alike. And I'm seeing that we wrestle a lot alike, too. I like the aggressive style. You know, in the past week, I had a couple of people come up to me and wanted to ask me about some of the comments, well, just like you did, that I've made. Well, everything that I say is predicated on the knowledge that I have about wrestling, and I would have to say that it's considerable. And in this case right here, I look at Arn Anderson, and I'm very pleasantly surprised. I'm very impressed. And I might say I'm kind of happy to see that he's in the family.
He is a strong young individual right now, though. Gene Ligon working on him with a headlock. Arn Anderson trying to hold on here.
You know, you look at it many times that I've been in holds and things like that, and I just like Derek. Gene Ligon might have thought he had something, but certainly all he's got is the other end of Arn Anderson. Arn was in control the whole time.
No doubt about it, just planning what he was going to do next.
Sure. I told you last week, I said, you've got to look 5, 6, 7, maybe 10 moves ahead. Gene Ligon was moving one move at a time. It wasn't enough.
And we talked about this last week, the Anderson family, they mean wrestling. And, of course, Arn Anderson comes into a match as Ole would or anybody else in the Anderson family, knowing exactly what you're going to move after move, what you're going to do. You have the whole match plotted out, mapped out what you're going to do, and it usually, always, it seems, ends up in a victory.
Well, you have to know what you're going to do. It goes without saying, and it sounds so simple, but you'd be surprised how many people walk out there and they're mesmerized by the crowd. They're intimidated by their opponent. And they suddenly realize a lot of things that they've been saying to themselves, to their girlfriends, to their wives, or whatever, they have to prove it now. They're out there in the spotlight. In wrestling, you're one person all by yourself. Not like football. You can blame the failure on 10, 12, 15, 20, 40 other people if you want. Baseball the same way. Basketball the same way. Hockey the same way. But wrestling is the only sport where that individual in the ring is solely responsible for everything that he does. If he wins because he's better. If he loses because the other man was better. And Anderson just doesn't know how to lose. And I think Arn is carrying on the tradition magnificently.
Last time we saw Arn Anderson, he worked on the arm and eventually broke the arm of his opponent. Now it seems he's going a different approach. He hasn't really worked on the arm in this match.
Well, think about it. I'm sure a lot of people have already heard about Arn Anderson breaking the arm. Now, as distasteful as that might be, I think everybody has to understand that in wrestling, somebody's going to get hurt. That's the idea of the wrestling match to begin with, to defeat your opponent. In our case, as Andersons, we used to always say, go ahead and give them a little taste of punishment because that way they won't come back. That way they won't talk about how good they could have done or how they may do later on. Arn is switching because a lot of people said, watch the arm, watch the arm. Gene Ligon is watching the arm. Arn Anderson's going to the head.
And doing it quite well. Arn Anderson there with a big slam. Going up now towards the turnbuckles. Well, that time Gene Ligon caught him. He caught him, and now what he has to do is stay on top of him. But Arn Anderson has really had the upper hand in all of this match. No doubt about it. Arn Anderson, every bit as good as we had heard. And, of course, just carrying on the Anderson name, Ole. No doubt about that. Now he says, here we go. Whoa!
Wow. There's something I haven't seen. The kid has really got a couple of moves. I hope we can take a look at that again because Gene Ligon landed right smack on his face the way it looked to me.
It looked like he was setting him up for a vertical suplex, but then actually he reversed it to the surprise of everyone here. We're going to see that once again. Ole, take a good look at it.
I tell you, you're right. I thought he was going back. He ended up taking that man right up in the air, and he drops him right back down. Watch it real close, right on his face. Oh.
A devastating move and another win once again for Arn Anderson, Ole.
A pretty good move, a pretty good move. And, of course, once again, I guarantee you that when the guy goes home, he's not going to be able to say to anybody, well, I could beat Arn next time I see him, or I'm going to be better, because that kid has got a few bruises on him that aren't going to go away too easily.
Okay, we're joined at ringside by Thunderbolt Patterson.
Well, you know, I don't have very much to say. It's just, you know, you got to change your heart, it seems like, you know, I know this is blood is a little deeper than water and everything, and Ken is run kind of deep and all, but you know, it was a time when you didn't go for, you know, rough tactics like that. And just because he's your kin, you can't uphold what he's doing.
What about that?
I can understand him being a great wrestler.
You know, I've had some time to think. And you ought to know probably as well as anybody the things that have happened to me in my life in the past, what, year, 6 months, whatever it is. And I think you know that I've done what I could do. But frankly, I finally realized maybe it doesn't do any good. Maybe it's a waste of time. I look at that kid, and you're right, I see an Anderson. I see what it can be. I don't see what somebody else wants me to make it. I see what it can be for me. I can see what it might do for that kid. And if you really stop and think about it, Bolt, if you give it some time and reflect on it, you're looking at me right now. I feel like I'm going back in time. Well, maybe that's what we ought to do. Maybe that's what we got to do. Maybe that's what it has to be. Maybe it's got to go back in time. Because if I look at it honestly, I look at you, and I look at Tommy Rich, and I look at, Dusty Rhodes. I look at this Magnum TA, and I realize, all of a sudden, like a light, when I see this kid, all of a sudden, I realize, you know what, Ole, you've been a kind of a dummy. You know why? No, wait a minute. Wait a minute. You know why? Because, Bolt, frankly, I've been carrying you. I've been carrying Tommy Rich. I've been carrying Dusty Rhodes. I've been carrying all of you. I've been carrying you. I can squat with 700 pounds and all of you together weigh a little bit more, and I'm just finally tired of it. You used to tell me how... Don't shake your head.
I mean, the people. The people told me. The people said, hey, look, there isn't anything changing. I mean, this is just the trinkets before you. You know, this goes way back. Way back. I mean, are you gonna be a liar?
No, I don't call it a liar. I don't call it a liar. I just wake up. No, wait a minute. Let me say something. They talk about, get that camera, and you say you look in a person's eyes and you can tell whether they're giving you any garbage, BSing you, so they call it.
Yeah.
You take a look, and you're gonna see in my eyes, you're gonna see the truth. I'm gonna just tell you right now, don't worry, I'm not gonna touch you. Not yet. I'm gonna tell you this. Today is a free day. Today is the day that you and I look at each other and I admit, nice guy that you were, whatever. But I helped you, you can't deny it. The days are over, I'm leaving. Next time I see you, I would suggest maybe you watch out.
Can you believe that? Those words from Ole Anderson, and like he said, a very, very serious man looking at Arn Anderson. And then remembering, as he said, the way it was. Ole Anderson, and that was very, very much a surprise, not only to me, but of course to Thunderbolt Patterson and all their friends, obviously very, very surprised with what had happened. Well, things happen here on Championship Wrestling from Georgia, and you were just witness to one of the biggest things that ever happened. Let's bring in right now